Not Like Us, Kendrick Lamar music video. Let's get after it. I'm excited.
We're getting after it right now.
Oh, yeah. Reincarnated, I'm a stargazing. Life goes on, honey, and all my babies. Woke up looking for the broccoli.
Hold up.
Keep a horn on me, deck of my seat. IP ownership, the blueprint is by me. Mr. Get Off, I get off at my feet.
Okay.
What is that, bro?
Previewing a little music, a little new music.
Yeah, like that flow is crazy.
That shit went hard, right?
Yeah, but he, in the Good Kid, Mad City times, he did that in a video and then the song never dropped, I heard.
The beginning of the All Right video.
Yeah, and they never released the track, I guess. Yeah. So
I hope that's not the case with that, because that sounded like it could be one of Kendrick's best songs. That shit went crazy.
If he's actually doing an album rollout, though, maybe that's the next single or something.
Yeah, that'd be fire. That shit sounded hot.
But all right, let's get into the actual.
Low-key, like, run that season. Back. I ain't even gonna lie. Run that back real quick. That shit went hard, bro.
That was a rewind sound for the record.
I am reincarnated. I'm a stargazing. Life goes on. I need all my babies. Woke up looking for the broccoli. High key, keep a horn on me. Deck of my seat. IP ownership. The blueprint is by me. Mr. Get Off. I get off at my feet.
Yeah, that shit's hard.
Yeah. But now, right. Okay. Now, actually, the Not Like Us music video. Here we go.
What's the password?
That's who it is,
Tommy,
man.
Tommy, the goat.
It's Tommy the Clown, bro.
If you watch the Ken and Friends live concert,
yeah,
you saw this.
Yeah, you
know. Late.
Put it on that beat, go. Hi. Mustard on the beat, ho, Debo, any rap, nigga, yep. He a freak, though, man, damn, call an ambulance, tell him, breathe, bro.
One thing I want to mention, like, throughout this video, Kendrick, there's, like, a lot of different locations that he shot at, and, like, he's wearing a lot of different outfits. Like, his outfits in this video go so
this
crazy.
Outfit is fire, I'll say that.
And, like, I like it. The black one with the jacket later, like, I love that fit.
I low-key like this one maybe the most. Yeah, because this
that
shit goes hard.
That hat is crazy.
Just, like, simple white with a nice blue hat and shit. But yeah, one thing I'll say is we saw this dance group during the pop-out. I forget their name, but yeah, this is them again. I'm sorry for forgetting their name.
I don't remember it either.
Okay.
That's all you had.
I just wanted to say, yeah, like, these are familiar faces that we saw and shout out, but I'm sorry that I don't know their name.
Nella nigga to the cross, he walk around like Tizo. What's up with these jabroni ass niggas trying to see Compton? The industry can hate me, fuck them all and they mama. How many ops you really got? I mean, it's too many options. I'm finna pass on this body, I'm John Stockton. Beat your ass and hide the Bible if God watching. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas.
I love that part when they hide the
passing
Bible.
Passing the Bible, yeah.
So good. And then next location right here, right away. Like, they put together this video really well. It's a good video.
And then this is where, like, this is, like, the hardest beat drop in the whole song.
Bible of God watching. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas. Certified boogie man, I'm the one that up to score with him. Walking down whole time, I know he got some hoe in him. Pull on him, extort shit, bully the flow on him. Say, Drake, I hear you like I'm young.
Doing push-ups?
Yep, 50.
You know.
Drake said, drop and give me 50. Kendrick said, all right, say less.
You better not ever go to cell block one.
And you know when Drake said, I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up, people are saying that picture is Drake's face
turned around
on the ground. So
okay.
That's just, I don't know if that's confirmed, but that's what people are saying.
Probably not, but.
Yeah, but the push-ups is clearly a response to the Drake.
Yeah, drop and give me 50. Come on now.
To any bitch that talk to him and they in love, just make sure you hide your little sister from him. They tell me Chubb's the only one that get your hand-me-downs. And party at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boys, certified pedophiles. Wop, 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 wop. That fuck him up. Wop, 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 wop. I'ma do my
man.
No OV hoes were harmed during the filming of this video. That
this just
amazing.
Feels like, man, I don't... I don't even know what to say. Like, I remember.
Fuck 'em up. Dude,
so good, dude.
I mean, I don't know. You remember we talked about the beef before it even popped off like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, before it even popped off, we're like, we gave our opinions who's going to win and shit. I mean, I knew Kendrick was going to win, like, in my heart, but Jesus, man. Like, he's just stomping on his man's face, bro. This shit is not even close. I didn't think it was really going to be that close, but like, bro, this shit is really a blowout. No.
Record just like went so big that you had to make a video and just keep it going. I mean, it went number one.
What a score is even. I saw that earlier. Like, it was Push Ups Euphoria, you know what I'm saying, which I'm giving to Euphoria. Then it was 6:16 and Taylor Made, which I'm giving to 6:16. Then it was
Family Matters Meet the Grams.
No, then it was fucking Meet the Grams. What was the one that came before Family Matters? Or The Heart. The Heart.
That was the last one.
Yeah, but yeah. So I guess you can, I guess Family Matters or Meet the Grams and then The Heart or Not Like Us. You know what I'm saying? It's, yeah. I don't know. Basically a sweet, I guess people were comparing Not Like Us and Family Matters because they're the two best songs technically of the, and they're the ones with exactly. The videos. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So,
those are the best too.
If you want to compare it that way, like it's a sweet, I don't know. It just feels like so much of a victory rap. Victory lap. He did the pop out. Now he's doing the video. It's like, does it end here? I don't know.
I mean, I hope so for Drake's sake. There's no way he doesn't. He can't respond at this point.
That's what I'm saying. Like, what? I'ma do my stuff. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord and it's probably A minor.
They not like us. Literally just hundreds of people calling Drake a pedo.
Yeah, and basically, yeah.
Like, that A minor, there's a crowd chanting. Yeah. They probably took that audio from the pop out. Because, man, it's just like, it's just such an iconic moment, it just feels like. Like, I don't know.
Nah, I mean.
It's so big for hip hop.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's definitely bigger than Hit 'Em Up, I feel like, now at this point.
Probably. And there's just so many more eyes on hip hop nowadays.
Right.
Like millions and millions.
Hit 'Em Up has had 20 years to fucking cook. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like, I don't know. And Hit 'Em Up is by far the biggest diss track before this. I mean, it's not even close, really.
I mean, this is easily. It's definitely the biggest diss track of all time. Best, I don't know, but biggest.
Well, I don't think Hit 'Em Up is even the best. I'd take Ether over Hit 'Em Up, but I'm saying Hit 'Em Up was the biggest.
Yeah.
Before this, for sure. And I don't know. I feel like this has surpassed it now. I'm not even going to lie.
It's huge. It's so fun, though. I'm here for it.
Oh, yeah. Come on. They not like us. You think the
Bay gonna let you disrespect Pac, nigga? I think that Oakland show gonna be your last stop, nigga. Mustard finally hops in. I mean,
you know,
he deserves to get some love, though. He made this beat, and the beat is what made this song so big. People just loved the beat. And then, I mean, obviously, Kendrick kills it. But this beat is just, like, a perfect.
It's pretty iconic. And now it's iconic, yeah.
Yeah, it's going to go down as one of the best hip-hop beats almost ever, probably. Like, yeah, it's maybe. Up there. It's so good. Cold foul, I don't know why you still pretending. What is the owl? Bird niggas and bird bitches go. The audience not dumb. Shape the stories how you want. Hey Drake, they're not slow. Rabbit hole is still deep. I can go further, I promise. Ain't there some be rest? That's for bitching. You Malibu most wanted. Ain't no love boy, you ball boy. Fish Gatorade or something. I feel like, and it's also nice to just like, it is weird that it's a whole song about calling Drake a pedo and Kendrick smiling and having so much fun, but it is nice to see him having so much fun again.
That's like, true.
Even though it's a dark twist.
I mean,
up situation.
That was the thing. I mean, Mr. Morale was the last thing he released in terms of like big music. So
besides a couple features. Yeah.
I mean, that's a pretty sore taste to leave in somebody's mouth. I mean, it's a good piece of art, you know what I'm saying? But it's so heavy in terms of like
lyrical content,
trauma.
Yeah.
Like, at least this is, yeah, something fun, like you said.
He's just vibing, you can tell. He's loving it. He's just soaking it all up.
Since 2009, I had this bitch jump.
That outfit, though, is hard. I like
that. Yeah, that shit really goes crazy.
You niggas will get a wedgie, be flipped over your boxes, or over your foe. The other vaginal option, pussy, nigga better straighten they posture. Got famous all up in content, might write this with a doctor. Tell a pop star, quit hiding, fuck a caption, won't action. No accident, I'm hands on, he fuck around, get polished.
Fucked on Wayne's girl. Well, he's in jail. That's conniving. Sorry.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I mean, yeah, let's just keep going.
Fucked on Wayne girl while he was in jail, that's conniving. Then get his face tatted like a bitch apologizing. I'm glad D Rose came home, y'all didn't deserve him neither. From Alondra down to Central, nigga better not speak on Sabina. Your homeboy needs subpoena, that predator moving flocks. That name gotta be registered and placed on neighborhood watch.
A lot of like old school street dance too that he's like really putting.
It's just crazy how many people like actually in like DeMar DeRozan just is in the video and shit. I mean, that's crazy, bro. Like, I don't know. It's just like everybody, bro. I feel like he's just on the train.
Yeah, but even if you don't have a even if you were close, not close, even if you're cool with Drake and Kendrick, you're just like a Sweden in the situation. If Kendrick asks you to be in the Not Like Us video,
but then
you just
but
do
then
it.
You're picking a side, though.
You have to.
Yeah, 100%.
This is
going to
be one of the most iconic rap videos of all time.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
This is going to have hundreds of millions of views in a few months. Like,
oh, yeah, no, I mean, yeah. This will be it's the biggest song of the year. One of the biggest of the decade.
Yeah, I would say yes.
Probably the biggest of the decade, yeah.
I lean on you niggas like another line of walk. Yeah, it's all eyes on me and I'ma send it up the pot. Ay, put the wrong label on me, I'ma get them dropped. Ay, sweet chin music and I won't pass the ox. Ay, how many stocks do I really have in stock? Ay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 + 5. Ay, devil is a lie, he a 69 god. Ay, freaky ass niggas need to stay their ass inside.
I actually, even that fit is kind of, I mean, it's just like a suit with no tie, but that he looks fresh in that. Oof. Like, he came out and killed it with the fits.
Oof. Yeah, and then we'll see Drake's state of being here in a minute.
Hey, roll their ass up like a fresh pack of Zod. Hey, city is back up, it's a must, we outside. Hey.
Yeah.
They not like us. 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 Once upon a
Yeah, back to the OG fit. But you can tell, like, they went all around the city and, like, filmed in a bunch of different spots with a bunch of different people. Like, I wish we lived out there so we could have went and been extras.
That's the thing. I heard NFR making this point, talking about this argument. They were saying, shout out, obviously, NFR. They were saying, do you think anybody right now could beat Kendrick in a rap battle? And I agree, it would be almost impossible because Kendrick's got the backing of the people. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like really anybody could come up and I don't know if they could step to Kendrick because Kendrick has the people.
I mean, the only person I could think of is the obvious one.
Who?
M.
I mean, no way. Not in 2024. Eminem's not seeing
Kendrick.
He's
the only one that has a chance. There's no one else that you could even argue
with. Maybe in 2005 or whatever, or 2004, 2003, 2002, maybe.
He's the only one that would even stand a chance, though. Name someone else who could even step in the ring.
In their prime. That's what I'm saying. Maybe M in his prime could.
Well,
but
who else?
Nobody really. I don't think.
I mean, yeah, in my personal opinion, it's M and Kendrick are like hip hop, like lyricism wise, those are one and two.
Like 95 Nas? I don't know. Who's stepping up? Shit. I don't know, man.
Big L? But,
well, yeah.
You know, like, I don't know who can rap like that.
I mean, that's the thing. Like, it doesn't even, like, regardless of skill at this point, he's just, that's kind of what the point is. Like, he's got the people already.
I mean,
like,
yeah,
everybody knows. Yeah, everybody knows you can rap. Like, it doesn't matter really how good you can rap technically at this point. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think, really, it didn't matter how good Drake was going to end up rapping. You know what I'm saying? Like, TaylorMade Freestyle, or not TaylorMade, but Family Matters is Drake's best song. We've held this opinion, but it was never going to be enough. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, it seems like.
Yeah, but at least it's not as embarrassing as if he just put out doo-doo the whole time.
No, I mean, it
could have been worse.
It's fucking me up that his most recent drops are so terrible. Like,
I mean,
after...
Those were all recorded during or before.
Okay,
like, he recorded those Camila Cabello songs
regardless,
over a year
though.
Ago.
Okay, but I'm not even talking about the Camila Cabello songs.
Well, which one? Wagwan Delilah? Yeah, that's...
Yeah, and the fucking...
That's like a joke, though.
Yeah, but and the Sexy Red one. Like, I just
that
feel like...
That one's stupid. But he
I mean,
slid
but that's
that.
Like the best one out of them. That's what I'm saying. Like, but I just feel like his releases after the beef could have, like, should have been a little bit more calculated. Like, I feel like he's just making it seem like, oh, I don't really give a fuck. Like,
yeah, but I think when he actually releases something, it will be. Like, when he himself puts
out
a Drake song,
I mean, we'll
I think
see.
There will be some more thought put in. Hopefully. I mean, he can't just put out a typical average pop song. Like, he has to come with something hardy next time.
I don't think he will. That's what I'm saying. Like, I think he's already shown that he's over it with dropping these random-ass, stupid-ass features.
But he hasn't dropped... Yeah, they're other people's music, though.
Yeah, but he has to clear him shit. And you don't think any of those verses have been recorded after the beef? 100%.
I think the sexy red one. That's it.
The rest well, I would say obviously that one was. And yeah. The WAG one, Delilah, I bet she was too.
Hard to say on that one. I just feel like
he's trying to make it seem like I don't take the shit seriously. But
I mean, yeah. And his Instagram captions are definitely like, he's like, whatever about it. But I mean, what else? Like
the worst. I don't know. I feel like that's the worst possible thing to do, though. I don't know. I mean, what I would do is not release for fucking 6 months and then just come out and fucking drop some shit that's actually good. I don't know. That's
probably what he's going to do.
But that's not what he did.
But he hasn't dropped anything. You're talking about other people's songs, though.
Yeah, but he's recorded music. I would
refuse. One sexy red feature?
No, there's been like 6 fucking songs that have released since the end of this.
It's Wagwan Delilah, the sexy red, and 2 Camila Cabello songs.
Wasn't it? I thought it was... Okay. Well, I thought it was 3... No, okay. Yeah, 2. 2 Camila Cabello.
And those were recorded almost 2 years ago. Like, that was way before, like, that was even a sperm cell.
I'm saying, though. Even the Wagwan Delilah and the fucking sexy... The sexy red one alone, I feel like. But I mean, maybe, yeah. Maybe not. Maybe I'm being a little too critical. It is a good point that they probably... The Camila Cabello ones, at least, were definitely recorded. But the Wagwan Delilah just left such a bad taste in my mouth, I feel like.
I mean, yeah.
I pray for him that he recorded that shit a long time ago.
I just really do believe that when Drake drops something... It's going to be better than his recent music because he has a lot to prove now. Like, he has to put out good shit or it's bad.
Yeah, because the sexy red one, I wasn't even that mad at. Like, it's really not that bad. Like, the BBL Drizzy beat is kind of fire. It does make sense to rap over it, obviously. Like, that's a funny move, you know what I'm saying? But then the Wagwan Delilah one just, like, was weird to me.
I mean, that is weird.
I just didn't get it. I don't know.
Yeah, it's a fucking weird Hey There Delilah cover on a weird
it's
Jamaican.
It's so weird. Thing. Like, it would be weird as fuck to release at any time, but then, like, directly after the biggest rap beef in history is, like, makes it extra weird to me. Like, weird. I don't know.
You know?
That's just my point, I guess. But yeah, let's move on.
Let's get it.
Time all of us was in chains. Homie still double down, calling us some slaves. Atlanta was the mecca, building railroads and trains. Bear with me for a second, let me put y'all on game. The settlers was using town folk to make them richer. Fast forward 2024, you got the same agenda. You run to Atlanta when you need a check balance. Let me break it down for you, this the real nigga challenge. You cuff.
I actually really like this part of the video that we're about to see. Like the little back and forth. He's like going back and forth with himself with the camera moves. It's kind of sweet, actually. I like this. This might be my favorite part.
The real nigga challenge. You caught Future when you didn't see the club. Like, what? Lil baby help you get your lingo up. What? 21 get your first street cred. Thug makes you feel like you a slime in your head. Like, what? Quavo said you can be from Northside. What? 2 Chainz say you good, but he lied. You run to Atlanta when you need a few dollars. No, you're not a colleague. You a fucking colonizer.
Uh-oh. Little teaser here real quick.
Yeah, right.
But I feel like that part... I don't know, like, whoever directed... I guess he directed this video.
Probably,
right? As we see
yeah.
at the end, I think it's him and unnamed person that you'll see later when the credits roll. But, like, I just feel like this video is, like... It's one of my favorite music videos ever, maybe. Like, it's so well thought out and put together.
It definitely... It seems, like, high production. Definitely.
Yeah, like, this is a fucking short film, basically.
Yeah, but, for sure. Right,
this next part had some people talking, as you know.
Not a colleague, you a fucking colonizer. The family matter and the truth of the matter. Here was God's plan to show y'all the liar. He a fan here. Freaky ass nigga here, 69 God.
So, if you didn't know, that's Whitney, Kendrick's baby mama, ex-fiance, whatever it is, but... After all this talk from Drake, Whitney hates him. They're not together. She had a kid with someone else.
He's abusive.
She's in the music video, Crip walking to the Not Like Us song.
With the son that he claims is Dave Freeze. And if you look at the fucking still, I don't know if you can go back. Actually, yeah, go back and pause it on the point where it's like the family photo type shit. And try to get his son's face in there. Because the ears are fucking identical, bro. I don't know if you've seen this, but... Him and his son's ears are literally identical. It's almost, it's probably hard to see there, but yeah, whatever. But yeah.
I mean, it's just hard to... There you go. There's
yeah, look at their ears, bro. Have you ever seen more similar ears than that? Look at the son and Kendrick. They're fucking identical.
I mean, it's hard to tell, but the ears do look the same just from this one view. But I actually don't know if I've ever seen Whitney just like... chill and so plain, but she's actually, like, super beautiful. Like, just, like, her face and hair, like, she's, like, dope. And she can dance.
Yeah.
Like, I just feel like it's so funny to have
Drake's grave.
Yeah, her being in the video is just, like, nail in the coffin.
Yeah, because I knew this was a still. I was like, okay, that's, you know, that's whatever. It's interesting. But then when I seen her crip walking, it was kind of funny.
Yeah, it's amazing.
The truth of the matter, it was God's plan to show y'all the liar. He a fan, he a fan, he a fan. He a fan, he a fan, he a freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Hey, run for your life. Hey, run for your life. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Hey, run for your life. Hey, run for your life.
Say O-V-Ho. Say O-V-Ho. Then step this way, step that way. Then step this way, step that way. Are you my friend?
Like, dude, so many people. It's crazy. All these people just hate Drake. It's amazing.
I don't know that they just hate Drake. They just love Kendrick. But now they might.
Step that way. Then step this way. Step that way.
What an iconic last shot, though.
Yep. Got the owl in a cage.
And then we get the credits that reveal. Directed by Dave Free and Kendrick Lamar. I mean,
Yep. You
don't really get much better than that.
Nail in the coffin, as they say, I guess.
It's Off the Top Podcast. Got you laughing like you hit the gas pack. Show is crazy like you watching Mad Max. Every other podcast is mad whack. Off the Top Podcast.